He will make it all right. Whatever we're going through, He's committed to making it all right. Can somebody shout all right? Glory to God. Hallelujah. That's the kind of God we serve. Take somebody's hand next to you and look at them and say, today, I'm sitting my faith with your faith in agreement to whatever it is that you are believing God for, it shall come to pass in Jesus' name. I agree with that. Yes, yes, yes. For where two touch and agree on anything, oh Jesus, God will acknowledge that and bring it to pass. Lift your hands to whatever. Father, we lift our hands to you in humble subjection. And as we submit ourselves to you, Lord, we thank you that you know how to pour your blessings into empty citrons. Now, God, we present ourselves to you empty. Now, fill us with every necessary blessing that will cause us to prosper, to be in health, even as our soul prospers. We thank you right now that we're receiving from you what man can't do. Thank you for the miracle that's taking place even as we lift our hands to you. And God, we thank you for word that's going to touch us and move us closer to you. Now have your way in this place. Anoint our ear gates that we might hear with priestly ears, and that we might all only be hearers but doers of that which we've heard. And it's in Jesus' name we kind of done by faith. If you agree with that, shout amen. Give God a big praise. Step by step, we'll make this journey if we just keep on marching up the King's highway. Every round is going to get higher. And for every new level, there's a new devil. But there's a God who's given us power over all of our enemies. Look at somebody and say, you're going to make it. Because God promised it. Come on, give God praise. The word of God to the people of God. And with your prayers and the help of the Holy Ghost, we want to preach this message into your hearing. Genesis, the 6th chapter, beginning at verse 1. And it came to pass, when men began to multiply on the face of the earth, and daughters were born unto them, that the sons of God saw the daughters of men, that they were fair, and they took them wives of all which they chose. And the Lord said, my spirit shall not always strive with man, for that he also is flesh, yet his days shall be 120 years. There were giants in the earth in those days, and also after that, when the sons of God came in unto the daughters of men, and they bare children to them, the same became mighty men, which were of old men of renown. And God saw that the wickedness of man was great upon the earth, and that every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. And it repented the Lord that he had made man on the earth, and it grieved him at his heart. And the Lord said, I will destroy man whom I have created from the face of the earth, both man and beast and creeping thing and the fowls of the air, for it repented me that I have made them. But Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. But Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Chapter 7, verse 1. And the Lord said unto Noah, come thou and all thy house into the ark, for thee have I seen righteous before me in this generation. And the Lord said unto Noah, come thou and all thy house into the ark, for thee have I seen righteous before me in this generation. Verse 8 in chapter 6. And Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Verse 1 in chapter 7. Because he was seen to be righteous. If you pray with us, we want to preach from this subject: living righteous in a fallen world. Living righteous in a fallen world. You may be seated in his presence. When we think of the word righteous, it simply means being in right standing with God. The righteousness of God through Jesus Christ puts us in a right standing with God. And therefore, because we are in right standing with God as believers, it makes us through Jesus Christ the righteousness of God. And inside of that righteousness, there was a promise given to us that's called eternal life. Only the righteous shall see God. We all shall look upon the face of Jesus. For the Bible said, when he shall descend from heaven, amen, and be caught by the cloud, as he make his platform, every eye shall see him. Every knee shall bow, and every tongue shall confess. But only the righteous shall see God. Everybody will see Jesus, but only the righteous shall see God. The good news is, amen, that we who have received Jesus Christ have this promise given to us that will be kept until the day of the Lord's return. We do not have to worry about it being ruled out or being voted out or being stripped away, because God, who promised it to us, have guaranteed us that the day will come that the righteous will look upon his face. I believe I'm looking at some people today, amen, that are waiting for that time. Amen, the time that we all shall see his face. When we look at the book of Genesis, we think about the book of beginning. Amen, as we reflect back, amen, into creation, we understand that not only did God make the creeping things and the fowl of the air and the mammals and things that swim in the sea, amen, but God made man. And he made man in his image and in his likeness. Amen. And because of that, man had a right standing with God from the beginning because he was the righteousness of God. But something happened in the garden that we all are aware of, and that is the man that God had created, he walked in disobedience and failed from his rightful place into a place where the curse and the wrath of God would be upon him until God made other arrangements. We understand the fall of Adam. And we understand, amen, the wickedness of men, how it played out in the earth. Amen. Even as we see it in our text today, amen, it talk about the wickedness of the world, amen, which provoked God's wrath. God's wrath was provoked because of the wickedness of men that were in the earth who chose, amen, to live by the lust of their flesh. And to live after the desires of their flesh and not to yield to the obedience of serving God. And we see here in the text, amen, how one Noah, amen, was found full of grace. And God himself, amen, saw this man in the earth as being different from all the others. And God chose him, amen, to save a generation. Amen, whereby that there will be continual life even after other life had been destroyed. So it talks about God's grace and how he found a grace in Noah and how in verse 1, chapter 7, the same God who saw grace, amen, also had seen the righteousness, amen, of Noah in the generation that he lived. And it talks about how the Lord instructed him to do something that had never been done before. Amen. He built an ark, a type of seagoing vessel. Amen. Never had it rained in the earth before. And here was a structure, amen, being constructed for something that had never been seen. And that is water, amen, floating a ship, if you will, or an ark or a building, amen, in their presence. Here he is, amen. He builds it. He pitches it, amen, with certain depth, and amen. And he describes the breadth thereof, and he talks about the length in which it should be built and how he should take seven, amen, sevens of the clean and put in, and two of the unclean male and female animals and put in the ark until he was further instructed. We know the story, but long story short, the Lord said unto Noah, because I've seen your righteousness in a fallen world, I'm going to allow you to survive my wrath, which is about to rain down on this generation. Bible talks about how it rained 40 days and 40 nights, glory to God, and every creeping thing upon the earth and everything that had life, amen, that was not inside of the ark, it perished from the wrath of God. The Lord told me to set forth a warning today, amen, as it was in the days of Noah, we shall see it again, and even in this generation, we can see the same activity. We can see the same evil spirit that's working in the hearts of men. Never have we seen such as we see today, amen, and it's so broadcast, amen, until we have become familiar with it and our tolerance have become so low until now we accept what's wrong to be right and what's right to be wrong. Have I got some help in here? We're living in that day, amen, where men would rather believe a lie than to believe the truth. How can we come to a place that we can accept same-sex marriage as if, glory to God, it was meant to be when God himself doesn't tolerate, nor has God created man to be with man, a woman to be with a woman. Oh, y'all don't hear. Oh, we're living in that day.